Don't get me wrong, I absolutely love Koenigsegg. But let's be honest, can a small startup company from Sweden actually beat one of the most historical automakers, which is backed up by the second largest automotive manufacturer in the world? Well, let's find out. So I have to give credit where credit is due. Koenigsegg is an absolutely sensational company. And when it comes to their engineering and their amazing inventions in the automotive industry, they're right up there at the top. Christian von Koenigsegg is basically Tony Stark in real life. But when it comes to Bugatti versus Koenigsegg, I have to say Bugatti will have the upper hand always. The thing is, I don't think Bugatti alone poses a threat to Koenigsegg. I think so, if Bugatti was still independent today, they would have never ventured into the hypercar game at all. I think so, they would have maybe made something like a big coupe or a big GT or a sedan or something of that sort in very limited amount of numbers. The reason why Bugatti is a threat to Koenigsegg is because of Volkswagen. If you've been living under a rock since the 2000s, Volkswagen is the second largest car manufacturer in the world, and they have one of the best and finest portfolios when it comes to owning automotive companies. They own Bugatti, Lamborghini, Porsche, Bentley, Audi, and a lot of other brands. The fact that Koenigsegg is even considering the same performance and technological bracket as a Bugatti Chiron is absolutely insane. And Christian von Koenigsegg has to be applauded for that. Because the thing is, Koenigsegg is still an independent firm, which means it has independent investors, and the money that they get in is significantly low than Bugatti when it comes to their R&D sector. The problem of Koenigsegg doesn't lie in the cars, absolutely not. In fact, if there is a car that can outrun a Bugatti, it has to be a Koenigsegg. And well, the real problem for Koenigsegg lies in their lack of resources. The thing is, since Bugatti is backed up by one of the largest automakers in the world, which is Volkswagen, the amount of resources that they have access to is absolutely crazy. The thing is, Volkswagen has an abundance of resources at their disposal. Test tracks, tire sponsors, engines, R&D centers, and most importantly, lots and lots and lots of money. Just think about it, if Bugatti needs any sort of help in developing a car, they can go to some of the best brands in the world. Let's take a hypothetical situation that Bugatti needs some help in developing a four-wheel drive system for their latest hypercar. And if they need some help, they can go to VW, and VW can arrange anything that they want because they have two of the greatest pioneers in the four-wheel drive industry, which is Audi and Porsche. I don't think Bugatti would have been a record holder for top speed records and acceleration records if it wasn't for Volkswagen. Koenigsegg have obliterated Bugatti in almost each and every way when it comes to world records, even if they're such a small company with a lack of resources. Just think about it, 0 to 400 back to 0 was obliterated by the Agera and was taken over from the Chiron Sport. They obliterated the Veyron Super Sport's top speed record with the Agera RS. But when it comes to the 300 mph plus world record, I think so Koenigsegg is just pushing a little bit above their limit. On both occasions for the top speed record that Bugatti attempted with the Veyron and Chiron Super Sport, Volkswagen had handed over the keys to their top secret high-speed facility called Aerolessen in Germany. Aerolessen is an insane testing facility for high-speed. It has an 8-mile-long test track, which is a dead straight, where basically Bugatti tops out all of their cars every single time. Just think about it, 8 miles long to top out your car. I mean, that's absolutely crazy. And when Bugatti took their latest Chiron Super Sport 300 Plus to the test track, they did a crazy 304.77 miles per hour, which is almost, not 500 kmph, but almost 500 kmph, touching 490 kmph in a street legal car. That is absolutely mad. Koenigsegg's last top speed run was done on a closed section highway in Nevada. As much as that's a crazy feat that they did this on a public highway which was closed down, I mean that is just one of their many limitations when it comes to the top speed game. First of all, Hats off to the owner who lended his $5 million plus Agera RS and the driver who had the balls to do this on a public road. I mean, just think about it. When it comes to a public road, let it be as smooth as possible. It has been used and it has been driven on. So it's never going to be as well maintained and as good as a proper testing facility. And that's where things just get blatantly dangerous. And that's where I think the Koenigsegg actually falls short. The thing is, this is not David versus Goliath. This is David versus David, but with one of the Davids having Goliath's powers. But now that Koenigsegg have unveiled their latest Jesko called the Absolute, they are predicting a top speed of 330 miles per hour with that car. And Christian von Koenigsegg himself said that after this car, they are not going to make another top speed world record holder for the road. And well, from the looks of that, I think so Koenigsegg is a very strong position for beating the Chiron Super Sport's top speed record. Well, thank you so much for watching. Let us know what you think about this video. Do you personally think Koenigsegg is going to beat Bugatti when it comes to top speed? Let us know in the comments down below, and thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.